Greetings people from Beer's Blend, my name is Ronald and welcome back to another video. Yes, I am not going to review these two here for you today. I'm going to do a comparison between the two. And well, some might say that it's kind of odd because this is a smoky Johnny Walker. This is not. The first one here is a Green Label, 15 years old. The other one is the new Gold Label Reserve, non-age statement blend. The difference in price is about $10 pounds. This one is about 30, 35. This one about 45, 50. Depends on where you get it. But I'm going to try to make my videos a little shorter if I can. So let's see how that goes today, by the way. That's a new thing here. By the way, yes, I am aware it's the middle of the winter. I am wearing a t-shirt. It's kind of hot in here. I have a lot of light shining on me, so yes. But the thing with these two blends is I reviewed this one, I believe. If not, then I will. And I did review this one in Dutch language. I didn't do this one in English yet, I believe. But yeah, I will look a little more closely into that, but yeah, if I didn't review these two, this is basically a more bourbon multi blend. This one is more smoky, aged, etc, etc. You get the idea. But the thing is, I recently, about a couple days ago, tried a glass of this one. This one has been sitting in a bottle for over a year now, I believe. This one was my first proper whiskey that I bought, I believe. Yeah, I think so. And well, this one I got about, I would say, half a year ago. I'm not quite sure. I am spoiled in whiskey, I know. But the thing is, this one turned smoky on me. I tried this, I opened it, and I got a lot of smoke. And I want to see if I get that today again. And it reminded me a lot of Green Label. And I am going to, check if that's the case. There is probably some smoky whiskey in here. Maybe not at all. But yeah, people who review this or on websites, nobody's actually saying that it's smoky or anything. It's more a bourbon blend than a smoky Isla blend. And I have to let my cat out. My god, I'm getting crazy. Can you open the door? No, you can't. Okay, well, I'll be right back. Always those stupid cats. Getting sick and tired of them. But yes, well, I am going to, check if it's still the case. If this one is still smoky. If not, then I will do a comparison nonetheless. But yeah, I thought this will be interesting. I mean, price-wise, there are a lot of discounts on Johnny Walker in general, at least in my area. And sometimes I can get this one for the price of that one. And yeah, just going to check which one is actually better. But yeah, let's just take a quick look if there's anything on the box. Well, this one is 15 years, this one is not. There has been a 18-year-old gold label, but that one has been replaced by the platinum label. So yeah, there is Skull Isla in here, Craigenmore, Linkwood and Talisker. I definitely need to try the Linkwood and the Craigenmore and the Skull Isla and the Talisker. None of these whiskies that are on the back of here, on the back of the box, I have actually tried. I will change that in the near future. Maybe there is something on the back of this one. They include casks from Kleinlisch, single malt whiskey, whose water, blah, 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 blah. Is this a Kleinlisch? The last time I took a look at the back of this box is about a year ago, so well, it only says Kleinlisch, and Kleinlisch is a little smoky, so maybe the Kleinlisch just develops over time in the bottle. I don't know, but that's really interesting. I will give Kleinlisch a shot though in the near future. I have two of my little Glen. Oh my god, it's actually a little dirty. Jesus. This is, well, a Glencairn glass, but then with a leg and a base on it, so I can turn around the whiskey in the glass. But this is actually a Glencairn shape, and it works really well. I highly recommend Glencairn glasses in general. But yeah, I also have some water here, just in case I might need to add any. But let's pour the whiskies, get rid of these boxes. Let's put them in the back here, where they don't bother me that much. Oh wow, same stopper on the corks. I didn't notice that earlier on. Let's let's pour some green label in this glass. Not a lot, just enough to check for any comparisons. Yeah, I can already feel the smoke. Some might say, well, color-wise, they look pretty close to each other. Well, yeah, Johnnie Walker uses E150 caramel colorant, so yeah, I do not want to mix up these glasses. Definitely smoky. There is a little smoke in here as well. Definitely. Yeah, now it's coming. The smoke in this one is more prolonged. It's more in your face. Well, because it has Islay whiskies. This one has Craigmore, which is a Highland Coastal malt. And has been known for being a little smoky. But yeah, I can definitely see some smoke in here. Actually a little sour. There is something quite sour in here. I don't know exactly what it is, but the smoke in this one isn't actually that strong because of the age. I would love if... Well, okay. It has been a long day. The thing I was about to say, I wish Johnnie Walker would just make a young, smoky blend. Yeah. I'm not going to say anything. I think, yeah, okay. There is definitely some sour hints in the gold label. By the way, these notes you are not going to get when you buy a bottle at first. This one has been sitting for quite a long time. I really need to finish this. But yeah, probably the thing that was going on in the bottle was that the Craigmore that's in there and all the other type of whiskies just oxidized a lot, and then the smokiness came. What is this? Kleinlish? Craigmore? What is in here? Kleinlish. This one has Craigmore. Yes. The Kleinlish in here probably just developed a lot, oxidized a lot, which filled the bottle with smoke hints, because it was really, really in my face when I opened it, and I was like, whoa, I can't remember having a smoky gold label before, and well, now I am getting more sour notes. I think I mixed up the... No, this one is definitely the smoke. Actually, though... You can definitely tell that some of the same whiskies are being used. Yeah, maybe that is the caramel colorant. I am not sure. I have never tried caramel colorant, E150 in particular, pure. But I can definitely see some smell, some... Yeah. Some resemblance. Actually, the gold label is a little harsher. This one is more mellow, but there's definitely more C notes in here. That's the case right from the start with the green label. But it has been aged. It's minimal 15 years old. So yeah, you are not getting the real harsh peat that you will find in a Lagavulin or Ardbeg 10, for example. If you want to get into smoky whiskies, then get some older smoky blends, or just some older smoky peaty whiskies in particular. The peat is less harsh, it's more mellow. And I think Green Label is more... Yeah. Mm. Yeah, okay, there's definitely more mouth coating, peatiness, smokiness in this one than you would get from the nose. But it's not that. Yeah. Hospital menthol smoke. It's more bonfirey. They said there is Kohlila. And I think Kohlila is a little bit more on the medicinal smoke side. Talisker is not, though. And Craigmore and Linkwood aren't smoky, I believe. Yeah, space side. Craigmore, space side. Yeah, they say Kohlila brings in the sea salt, peat smoke. Yeah, I am really, really going to get a bottle of Kohlila, I think. I think it will be a really good whiskey to enjoy. I am not really getting those caramel type notes, more of a sour fruity note. It's not unpleasant, it's interesting. I rather prefer the green label, but I really like the gold label in the beginning. It has just been sitting in a bottle for too long, I think. Mmm. Yeah, right away. I don't need to spend a lot of time with this one to figure the differences out. This one is mellow, nice, gentle. I am getting some smoke, though, in the aftertaste. At the back of my cheeks, there is a little smoky coat appearing, which is not present in the beginning of the taste or in the nose. The thing that is overruling in the nose with the gold label, at this moment in time, it is the sourness. It's not an unpleasant sourness, though. When I hear sourness in whiskey notes, whether it's the taste or the nose, I most of the time lose my appetite for that whiskey. But it's interesting sourness. It's not sour like you expect from food or anything. It's a hint from sourness, but it actually might be something different. It might be some cask influence. The sourness is fading now, so it has been sitting in the glass a lot now. And I think that was the case. I can still pick some sour hints. Yeah, there's definitely some sourness in here. Yeah, there's that smokiness again. Now I'm positive that indeed. Wow. If you leave a gold label in a bottle for a long time with a good amount of air in it, you actually get a smoky gold label. That's really interesting. And that's the thing with whiskies, you know. They develop over time. They develop a lot in the glass because of oxidization, etc. But it happens in the bottle the same way as it happens in the glass, but much slower, because the whiskey can just breathe here, and the air in the bottle is just what is in there. So it's much of a slower process. But the taste and the nose on the gold label are nothing alike. The taste is so pleasant. It is developed. It tastes like an aged whiskey. The taste from the unaged-stated gold label and the aged-stated green label aren't actually that much, aren't that different complexity and aged-wise. Yeah, there are casks in there. And there's a little spiciness appearing. I would actually love to try a 15-year-old Kol Ayla. And a 15-year-old Talisker, etc. I think 14, 15 years is actually a really interesting age for those more harsh, peaty whiskies. I'm going to take a look at the 15-year-old Lafroy. It is quite expensive, though, but I think that that might be a nice sweet spot for that type of whiskey. I would love to taste a little older Artback, actually. I would really like that. In the beginning, the Gold Label tastes a little younger. But then, the development, the aftertaste, it really comes alive and becomes complex and aged. But that might be because of the smokiness. A lot of young smoky whiskies hide the youngness fairly well because of the peaty and the smokiness. I can sense the Gold Label is a little younger because of the arrival, but the finish, I would guess it's around the same age as the Green Label. It's not. The development on the Gold Label is intense, nice, full. Full flavored. Orange. Oh, you get the idea. It tastes like an aged Gold Label Reserve. And well, whiskey doesn't age in the bottle. It ages in the cask. But it develops a lot more. And I cannot, for the life of me, remember this finish and this development on a Gold Label. The Gold Label is actually a little bit boring for me. That's why I haven't touched it for so long. Because it was just, well, bourbon cask finish. It was vanilla. It was basic. It's a really good entry whiskey. I suggest you try it if you want to get into whiskeys. Because there is a lot of different notes in there. Always have some water with you when you try whiskey side by side. And you should actually do this. This is the first time I've done this. Tried whiskey side by side. And I'm going to do more of these. Let me know if you have a nice roundup of different malts I should put head to head. I think I will call this series head to head, yeah, or cork to cork. The development and the finish is much more harsher on a Gold Label. That might be because of the Kleinlish. The finish, the development, the arrival is much more gentle. Yet every slightly more complexer than the Gold Label. Which one do I prefer? Well, the Green Label. Because from start to finish, nose-wise, it's mostly better. But I like the development and the finish more on the Gold Label. I would actually love if the Green Label was just a little bit more punchier. I think if it was 2 years younger, like 13 years, that would be the sweet spot for the Green Label. Or maybe even a little higher ABV. Keep in mind, by the way, that the Gold Label is 40%, this one is 43%. And the higher the alcohol percentage, in my opinion, the more flavors the whiskey carries over from the cask. Both very good. Close in price, which one should you get? It depends. Are you more of a citrusy, honey, vanilla, bourbon type of person? Get the Gold Label. Are you more into the more smoky bonfire, a little peppery seaside, seashore characteristics, get a green label. Or just get both. They aren't expensive. They are really good money, or value for money. There is that intensiveness from the green label, though. I can feel it prickling on my tongue. Green label is much more hard, of a gold label is much more powerful, though. But it fades kind of fast. The green label has a lingering aftertaste, a fuller aftertaste. Yeah, there still is that sour note, but it's not present in the gold label. If you open a bottle or just begin drinking it, that is just the case of oxidization a lot. Sometimes oxidization changes whiskey for the good, sometimes for the bad. Most of the time it changes the whiskey for the good, but it also may bring up some different flavors, etc., that might not be appealing to everyone. That's why the whole blending thing is popular with people who just want a basic malt, because blends can be complex, but blends are most often not really it's more of a one person kind of show, but that person is really interesting, you know what I mean? Instead of you have all these different things going on, it's just a nice good thing all around. That's the case with blends, and well, that's the differences between single malts and blends for you. Sweet arrival. There it comes, the more fruity, complex coastal development. The Kleinlish is definitely taking over in this in the gold label, and I think for the better. I am really digging these whiskies. I think that gold label might not live long. But, well, I thank you for watching. It was quite a long video, but yet, well, this is not a normal review. But it's under half an hour. That's nice. I thank you for watching. I hope you leave a like. If you have other, well, suggestions, that was a cat. If you have any other suggestions of which bottles I should put, well, head to head, leave it down below. And, well, I will catch you next time. Goodbye, and I'll see you later.